mighty Duckman, I swear to God. And I was like, Emilio! Emilio!
You're an idiot.
Like the video and subscribe.
Hello there and welcome to another video. My name is Sparckman, I'm a game developer, and today we are going to create an isometric game. Let me show you the demo. Here it is, nothing fancy. See that I can move in an isometric grid. Okay, so let's open the example file, which you are going to find under the description below. Now, if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there is a link down below where you can download the free version. There is also a link to the paid version, which allows you to make commercial games. Okay, so here is the example file. Let's go over the assets. We have these four objects, which are going to go around the ball. There's a shadow, which is just an ellipse. On the ball, you can see that it is a static object. Okay, so let's go to the event editor. Wow, it's really warm here. So I'm gonna try to make this super fast so I can get out of this room. And look who's behind me. He wants to get out too. All right, so let's create an always. Under the top object, position, select position relative to the ball. Spread out. Going to drag this to the rest of the objects, and you can see that now they're around the object. Under the shadow, we're going to place it below our character there. Now if the user clicks on one of the objects, the top object, then we change the position of the ball, select position relative to itself, and we can just drag this here, but we're gonna go -40, 20. Out. That works fine. Copy this. Select the down direction. And I'm going to edit this. And instead of -40, make it just 40 and just 20. Right out. Okay. Let's do the left and right. I'm going to copy this. Change it for right. I'm going to edit this. And we can just drag this manually, but we're just going to go 40. -20, and let's try it out. Press up. Down doesn't work yet. Copy line 4. Replace it for left. Let's edit this. And we're gonna invert it. -40 and just 20. Try it out. And you can see that this works fine. One more condition. At the start of the frame, we can make all this invisible. Under visibility, make invisible. Here it is. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you don't, give it a thumbs down. Alright, so thanks for watching. Don't forget to check out my other channel, which is over here. Your Sparckman vlog, subscribe to the channel, follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next episode.